Dear Mr. Prince, I hope you don't mind me calling that. I realize your name is simply Prince, and that referring to you as Mr. Prince makes it sound like you're a sixth grade English teacher rather than a Grammy Award winning artist. But my actual sixth grade English teacher, Mr. King, whose name suggests that he outranks you, but I doubt that's true, instructed us on writing formal letters, and he stressed the importance of addressing the recipient with the appropriate honorific. So I went with Mr., because I don't think you have you're a doctor or anything, unless you received one of those honorary PhDs that colleges sometimes dole out to celebrities, in which case, my deepest, sincerest apologies. Anyway, I know that you're a busy person, what with being a rock star and all, but if you can find a spare time to reply to this piece of fan mail, I'd really appreciate it, as I have a few burning questions about your 1983 pop hit, The Little Red Corvette. So I get it that the song is not really about a car. It's about a woman who is hot and she sleeps around a lot. And the narrator is attracted to her, but also intimidated by her seemingly insatiable sexual appetite. And I appreciate your use of metaphor to illustrate this woman's prolific sexual proclivities, such as that line about her having, quote, a pocket full of condoms, Trojan, and some of them used, end quote. But my question to you is, why does this woman have so many used condoms on her person? I could understand if she had just had sex, like right before the song started. She may have wrapped that one used condom up in some tissue and held onto it until she found a discreet waste receptacle somewhere. But your lyrics seem to suggest that she's carrying around a multiplicity of condoms. So is she collecting them, like some people collect baseball cards or stamps? And I get that Trojan is reference the Trojan brand condoms. That much is clear. But why do you euphemistically refer to such condoms as horses? After all, Trojans are not horses, but rather the people who inhabited the ancient city of Troy. Now, some listeners might contend that there was that one really famous Trojan horse. But if you consult the texts of ancient epic poems, such as Homer's Odyssey or Virgil's Aeneid, they will confirm that the so-called Trojan horse wasn't an actual horse at all, but rather a giant fake wooden horse with an opening in the belly that Greek warriors poured out of, which, by natural extension of this metaphor, implies that the condoms this woman in the song is carrying must have holes in them. This also suggests that the sperm are the microscopic metaphorical equivalent of ancient Greek warriors. Is this what you were trying to convey in this passage? Then there's the second verse, where they go back to the woman's home, which the narrator describes as, quote, the place where her horses run free. Since we already established that horses are a reference, albeit an ill-advised one, the Trojan brand prophylactics, this line seems to suggest that her home has magical properties that somehow animate condoms, thereby allowing them to move about on their own accord. Is this actually the case? Please elaborate. The reason why I ask is that in the same verse, refer to this woman's past lovers as jockeys. Less observant listeners might presume that you mean that these men wore condoms in much the same way that jockeys wear horses, which you have to admit, sounds pretty silly, not to mention anatomically incorrect. Alternatively, if this woman's abode does have magical properties that burn condoms to life, then perhaps these men were literally riding these condoms, much like jockeys ride horses, as they raced around her apartment. Or is it a house? Or a loft? The type of dwelling is not specified either. This is yet another question that the song leaves unanswered. Anyway, I look forward to hearing your clarifications on all these matters. Sincerely, Ms. Cataclysm.